up in my tummy and I feel like I'm loving you. Love you such a sweet thing, good nothing, weak thing, and just what I'm gonna do. Ooh, love to hold ya, ooh, love to kiss ya, ooh, love, I love it so. Ooh, love is sweeter, sweeter than sugar. Ooh, love, I won't let you go.
I love this song. You guys remember the Ohio Players? This is some good shit. Oh God, I'm drinking cranberry juice or pomegranate juice. Woo! Tastes good, actually. I like it. Damn, it's some good pucker stuff. All right, we're gonna go live in about 30, 40 seconds. But first, we're gonna get some love in your tummy. I have no bra. And I'm in boxer shorts. Okay, I promise I'm gonna start my video, but I have to rock out a little bit before I chit chat with you folks. Hey everyone, what's going on? Corey Draper right here. If you're on my live Facebook feed, hello. Ohio Players. I love this stuff. All right, let's go live. All right, it's in the 11 o'clock hour here in Salt Lake City. I will be Corey Draper. And you guys just be cool. You guys just rock your asses off with me. It's a super grass. This is the song off Dumb and Dumber, one of the best movies ever filmed in Salt Lake City with Jim Carrey and Jeff Daniels. This song puts me in a good mood. So I recommend if you ever go live on video and you're shy and you just don't want to be seen. I don't want no one to see me on Facebook, my hair, my makeup. Oh, I wonder if I mess up and I don't know what to say. No one cares. They just want to see you. They want to prove you're real. You're not a catfish. You're not a guy named Bob posing as a lovely girl named Cindy Crawford. You're not a girl named Cindy Crawford posing as a guy named Jeff Daniels. They just want to know you're real. That's all. So do what I do. Go live on Facebook. Put on a cool hat, the Punisher. Get your favorite skull wrist thing. What's this called? Like a, is that a necklace? What is it called when it's on your wrist? And then crank Supergrass. No one remembers this song except me. It's because I'm a big fan of Dumb and Dumber. They filmed it at the Salt Lake Airport. They filmed it a lot in Park City and Deer Valley, although they pretended it was Aspen, Colorado. But you put this song on, trust me, you're gonna be in a good mood. So let's crank a little bit, and then we're gonna get busy. Get a pen, get a paper. I record this, so you don't even have to if you don't want to, but just relax and be yourself, and let's rock out just a little bit more. Because I got to have one more little sippy in my cuppy of hot, warm, delicious pomegranate juice. You know, I really like it, to be honest. I can't eat pomegranate stuff because, you know, when you try to eat them and, you know, everyone has a, they have like a way to eat pomegranates. You know, some people just dig right in. They don't give a crap, man. They got blood all over them. They look like the end of Carrie with Sissy Spacek in 1977. And they've got red all over them. They, you know, look like a big mess. And they don't care. They're just pomegranates. It's all over their fingers. And it's just, then they pick their eyes. And then they go like this. And then they go and they go, oh, hey, Corey, what's up, man? They go to shake your hand. And they've got like pomegranate red stain all over themselves. That's not the correct way to eat pomegranate stuff. What you do is you go to the store and they already have it like out, those little individual little pomegranate, and you can get it in juice form too. I mean, how convenient. Look at that. It's literally stained. Can you see that? Look at the ring. That's pure pomegranate. It's actually ice cold. I said it was warm. I lied. But my God, look at what it does to my coffee cup. it stains the living bejesus out of it. Imagine what my teeth are going to look like in the morning. Holy crap. All right. If you're worried about doing live video, oh my God, go like this. Make sure you look okay. Just put glasses on like I do. That way when I'm reading or I lose track, no one can tell. Just look in the camera. And remember, everybody loves when people first start doing video because you look nervous. You're freaking out. I love it. Not to bring in the booby business, but if you've ever been to a gentleman's club, and I accidentally owned one or two here in Salt Lake City, but nothing's more fun when someone comes out and they're going to try to dance, and you know their dance name is like Lexus, Mercedes, Granada, Corsica, Corinthian. I've heard the most darndest names, but I love when a girl comes out and she's just like, you know, and the first thing they do is they think like when you're kind of a stripper, let's so to speak, like the movie Showgirls, they get out there and they kind of dance fast, you know? And guys are like, God, I think she's new. You know, and then they do like, you know, they're just totally freaking out, man. Like something you do to a Bee Gees song. And then after a while, they kind of go through this learning curve where it's kind of like less is more and just kind of get smooth. And then, you know, within a month, that girl that was just freaking out, like Midnight Star, no parking on the dance floor, or Wham! UK before George Michael went solo. You guys remember how badass that album was. But all of a sudden, through the learning curve, the girl kind of figures it out. You can do the same thing if you guys go on live video. And if you guys, you know, are over in Asian countries or over in that weird country, is it London? What's going on? Tell me, who really did build Stonehenge? I'm like so tired of watching all those cool videos on YouTube about Stonehenge. You know, those big giant boulders that are just sticking up like a sundial, and like 45,000 years ago, a bunch of guys and girls just said, hey, let's just move a bunch of stone from this location 100 miles away, and we're going to build kind of like a sundial. It's going to take about 100 or so years, but no problem. We have no cable yet. We have no intranet. But we're just going to build something kind of cool for 100 years, like those cats over next door that are building pyramids. You know, tell me, who built it? Because you guys have inside information over there in England. Don't bullshit me. I can tell. All right. Okay. Let's have a shindig. You guys that come to all my trainings every day, every night, you guys know I don't have meetings. I don't have conferences. I have shindigs. So what I want to do tonight is ask you guys some questions and you guys pretend to give a rat's ass. Okay. You guys ready? Okay. Let's do it. First, I have to flip my pony. Okay. Can I make money online or just from working at home? I mean, can I do that? That's like one of the biggest questions ever. Besides who shot JR, who shot JFK? I mean, there's a lot of questions. Who killed Jimmy Hoffa? There's all these mysteries out there. But one of the most asked questions on Google, and you can look this up, because I wouldn't lie to you guys, no way. I'm just not that type of guy. Can I make money online? Like, really, can I? Can I do it working from home? Okay, well, just ask yourself this. Can I make money online? How much money have you spent online is a better question. Because right now, thanks to Amazon, there's no Kmart, JCPenney, Costco, Piggly Wiggly's. Every brick and mortar store is kind of taking it in the butt, except for like Walmart, Target's hanging in there. But can you make money online? Yeah, because it takes money from somebody to go like this. They have to spend. And right now, my God, everybody is spending like crazy. Nothing's greater than putting your credit card in a little thing. And then you go to Amazon and it's almost like it's free, really. I know a couple wives out there, their husbands are at work all day and they're like, my husband's going to kick my ass when he gets home. He's going to yell at me because they just every day, well, I need this, 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 this. And then, you know, day or two later, man, it's like Christmas. There's just every week is just Amazon stuff coming from, you know, pink toilet plungers, chocolate flavored Cialis pills, shelves for the garage. I mean, there's so much cool stuff on Amazon. So can I make money online? Yeah, because you're spending money online. Can I do it from home? Yeah. Because do you realize that like half the products on Amazon are not owned by Amazon? Now, sure, they have their own inventory of certain things. And if you guys know the story of Amazon, it was mostly they started with books. The world's richest dude, it's got about 170 billion with a B, which is 1.7 million, if I remember right. But, you know, he just had an idea. He's like, you know what? There's all these great used books, but if they don't make it to libraries or they get to like schools, high schools or grade schools or whatever, but you know, you don't want to throw away books. It's kind of stupid just because they're read once. He just thought, you know, why don't we go ahead and just, you know, specialize in, you know, selling books that are used. As long as they're in decent condition, there's a value. Some of them are worth 1 million, but some of them might've been 12 bucks and now they're worth $2. But if you look at Amazon, my gosh, what a great idea. But he just started in the book biz. And now obviously, if you've got a bunch of cool stuff, let's say 1,000 widgets, you send them to Amazon. Once they get them and inventory them and they can control the shipping of those 1,000 widgets, all of a sudden, bam, you got a business. Are you at home? Yeah, you could be at home. Why would you get an office and do all this stuff if you're going to try to just resell items on Amazon? So of course you can make money at home because people are spending at home so out of control, it's batshit crazy. And of course you can work at home. You can work at home, yes, in your pajamas, in your $4 truck stop tank top, in your boxer shorts, in your favorite pajamas. You can do all that cool stuff. And can you just, you know, can you sell this, that? What do I sell? You know, God, you can just go crazy with that. But in my case, I like to sell something that's already been created. It never gets outdated. I'm not going to sell the pet rock, even though that's kind of cool. If you're from the 70s, people were painting rocks. And it was kind of a fad, kind of like the Rubik's Cube. There's a lot of stuff that just comes and goes, but they're still badass. And then over 30 years, all of a sudden, Stretch Armstrong, this doll that you just go like this with jelly inside, all of a sudden, you're just, I want to have another one of those. I want the Evel Knievel, that motorcycle that you crank like this. Boom. I want a Light Bright. Who remembers Tinker Toys, Lincoln Logs? I play with Legos now more than myself. It's unbelievable. I'm shocked at how many Lego kits I have right now. So, you know, but do I own Lego? Do I want to resell Lego? I kind of wouldn't mind really because I'm really into Lego kits. It's just crazy, the addiction of that darn thing. But I really don't even want to resell a product, even though I really enjoy it. But if I want to sell something, I want to sell something that's already created. It's really not out of date. It's always going to be somewhat badass. And you don't have to store it. You don't have to buy it each month. It's not MLM. You couldn't, you know, unless someone put like maybe a gun or to my head or wanted to steal my Punisher cap. That's $9 at Walmart right now. I'm not going to sell shampoo conditioners. I'm not going to do MLM. I'm not going to do anything that you have to sell each month and 2 by 2 equals 4 and 5 equals 9. And all of a sudden the buy price of the widget in the maniform means that you can make this much money. And then you got to pretend to give a shit. And you don't even remember even how the pay structure is. All you do is just do a lot of work. And at the end of the day, you're like, I got a lot of shampoo and conditioners. I bugged all my friends and family. They all pretty much want to punch me in the face. But at least during Christmas, I can give away all my shampoo and vitamins and all the crap that my MLM made me buy so I can make $42 over 12 months. So I don't do MLM. And there's some great MLM products out there, companies. I don't want to sell something that's outdated. They ain't going to do it. There's great courses how to sell on Amazon. There's more billions made on Amazon. It's just mind-blowing. It's an awesome infrastructure. I just don't want to do that either. What I don't feel bad about if I want to sell something that I didn't create is I don't mind selling. If I have to sell something, I don't mind selling education, but I don't want to sell it myself. I don't want to create it. I sound like a little bitch, don't I? I mean, don't I sound like, wow, talk about wanting your cake and eat it too. Like, Corey, what the hell do you want to do? You know, what do you want? Just a free check in the mail? Buy a shiny ball and all of a sudden you make like $1 million over 12 months. No, I just want not to be embarrassed. If someone wants to do what I do, form a friendship with me, maybe we hang out, maybe we're Facebook friends, but I wouldn't mind having, you know, business like-minded individuals, friends of mine for the next 25 years if I live that long. I hope I do. I plan on it, gosh darn it. I got a lot of Lego kits to build. But there is such a thing as profiting off something that you're so-called selling. I like to sell information. You don't have to put it in your garage. I don't have to do a minimum each month in order to get paid. It is not MLM. I sure in the hell don't have to do much other than just kind of hint, or just lightly tell people about what I do in a fun way. Or maybe I just go ahead and send postcards out like, you know, the old days. Still effective. There's a lot of people out there bullheaded. Like, you don't have like a guy 60 that's like, man, I'll tell you what, when I used to drive a truck, God damn it, we had 18 speeds and we did this. And the best breakfast was Lou's Cafeteria in Galveston, Texas. And all that damn internet and all that digital logs in my semi-truck's all bullshit. But that guy loves mail. His wife probably likes mail. And yes, postcards can be effective. So if you think you can spread information through postcards, great. If you can do it by doing just live videos, being kind of a crazy guy like what I'm doing right now, great. I want you to get a hold of me because that's my favorite way to let people know what I do. You can just, you know, buy leads. And what that is there's kick-ass companies out there and they capture people's email addresses, maybe even their names. It don't even matter if it's their fake name. As long as it goes to a real, legit email address. And this person named Elvis Presley, who maybe has, you know, elvispresleykicksass@gmail.com. But even though that guy gives a fake, you know, name, as long as you get a legit email address, because he just wants to remain private, but he just wants to know, hey, can I make money at home? Can I get people to look at my website? Can I do a couple things? I just want to know. So somebody please send me something. So I go ahead and just buy that lead. Okay, that's as stupid as simple as I can make it. But in the biz term, when you start doing it a long time like myself, you know, it's called solo ads. Solo meaning one person who might have an ad or they're looking for a biz op that wants to know, can I make money at home? Can I sell something? Can I get more eyeballs to my website? There's so many people doing this right now. And you can go to Google Trends and you can just ask Google, what's the number one searched item? You know? Google's pretty cool. I mean, I know they dominate. They kick some major ass. Some people hate Facebook. Some people know everything about all that stuff. But at the end of the day, it's pretty badass about how much information you can get, you know, for free. But yes, there are people out there that they want to buy information because usually it's from somebody that maybe has lost money, made money, but they've put more thought and they have more integrity. And they're like, you know what? I've learned the hard way. So if I can sell information for $100, $500, $1,000. I live in Utah, in the University of Utah. You know what they do? They offer courses for $5,000. You know, for $20,000, you can get an education for a year. And guess what? You can also get a shitty dorm or no dorm at all. And over that year, you can meet pretty girls, rad badass guys. You can get drunk every night and you can party your ass off, you know, for 20 grand. And then afterwards, you can go back to your parents and go, man, I did the best I could. I think I got a good education. I know that I got all D minuses and stuff and my attendance was 50%. But you know what I learned? I love to just party, sleep in, and oh my God, I want to go to Arizona State because they have the best parties by far. That's what you can get for 20 grand if you want to spend 20 grand. So then you got to ask yourself, well, do people pay for education? Or if you listen to politics, everything's free. Oh my God, we're going to get free college. We're going to get free everything. I'm not betting on that. I'm out of time. I have silver face syndrome. I'm turning into the colonel. Next year, I'm going to look like the Kentucky Fried Chicken guy. Because yes, I'm a little older than you guys that are maybe lucky enough to be teenagers or 20-year-old. I'm jealous of you guys because I can't get my time back. I cannot value time enough. And you know what? I took it for granted because if you are 20, 30, even 40, even 45, I'm jealous. I got 10 years on you cats. I can't get that back. What's 365 times 10? And that what, 7.5 million? That's 7 million days I can't get back. So when it comes down to time and you're a little older like myself, and I will never ask a lady's age, that's just not gentleman-like. But I'll tell you what, if I can get education a little quicker, I can get it on my computer, I can read it. If I don't understand it, reread it. I can print it out and take it with me. If I want to watch videos of it, sit in your underwear and watch the video. If you don't understand it, repeat, listen to it again, take notes, try to comprehend it. Dang it, I can't remember what that guy said. Repeat it. That's the beauty of education online. I 100% recommend online education over college, unless doctor, lawyer, super targeted, you know, career, Or you need a GED or a BFD so you can get an ABC of element OP. But you guys know what I mean. I mean, there's some things that you absolutely have to go to, either a city college, a college, or something even bigger than that. I mean, you know, but if you just need some random information about how life works, how the Golden Gate Bridge was built, how do they make cement? How do you make money online? Can you do it at home? Can you do it without sales? Because that's the third thing I usually search for. Am I going to dress up tonight to go to work? No. Am I going to dress up in the morning? Because it's nighttime here where I'm at. I speak like I'm over in Europe and Asia right now, but I'm not going to dress up in a suit. I'm not going to put my hair in a ponytail, cover my tattoos. As you can tell, I've got a couple. That's right. They're all over my back. They are on my arms. It's pretty embarrassing. I've got one, an 80s girl with Oakley blades. Do you think I'm going to show up to sell something tomorrow in a tank top with a girl from 1987 in Oakley blades? Yeah, if I sell pot for a living, maybe, or something. And then, of course, I thought it was in my best interest to put a badass snake on my arm. Hi, sir. I'm Corey. How you doing today? What would you like to buy? Well, I don't know, man. Is that a snake on your arm? Yeah, but it's not as crazy as the Black Panther, but I've got that beat. Am I going to go sell something in a tank top when you have a mermaid that's topless? Look at that. I thought that was in my best interest 35 years ago. I've got a topless mermaid, and she's got nipples and everything, and they're pink. I got glow-in-the-dark pink ink. I thought that was pretty cool back then. So am I going to dress up and go sell something? No, I can guarantee you that. I'll bet you $1 million I ain't going to do that. But if someone else will do all the sales for me, thank you. And you can have 50% of it, even Steven. All right. So I like to sell information, but I don't like to sell it myself. I like to sell information online, but I do not like to make the video or the PDF or the printable information of that. I want to sell information by people that are more educated than me, that have maybe made a million, or maybe they have built a website, or they know how to market something. I want education from people that have actually done it. I don't even want a paid person that makes $52,000 a year at the University of Utah, which is kick-ass. It's right behind my studio here, you know, about 10 minutes. I don't want to learn from someone that has been paid to teach me about something, who take all the summers off. I don't. The only teacher I want is Jack Black, the School of Rock. I will go to that school, and I will rock my ass off to AC/DC songs. That's the only thing I'm going to get dressed up for. And the reason why is because I can wear a tank top like this. And if I think Jack Black is my teacher, he'll probably go, you know what? You kind of look like you play drums. That's the only thing I'm going to do. But I want to sell information too, because it's not outdated. And if it is outdated, how easy is it for a company to update education or to find an expert and go, you know what? If I give you $5,000 to $10,000, will you design a series of education that we can market with our company? Because we're a company that sells information, digital product. The digital product is something like selling information. When you buy it with a credit card, it just comes in your email rather quickly. Sometimes it might take an hour or two. Sometimes maybe it'll be even overnight because your credit card needs to be approved or something like that. But at the end of the day, most people, and you guys have probably bought something like this, maybe another course. I bought 20 something years. I love online opportunities. I've studied all MLMs. And so I have 20 years ahead of you if you've never done it before, because I know what I don't want. I just don't want to sell, but I love to sell something. I want to sell something that's not outdated. And in the best thing that I feel good about myself. And if I did honestly sell you something right now, Corey, to you, if it's information, I don't feel guilty about that. I don't want to sell you shampoo. I'm not going to sell you vitamins. I'm not going to sell you anything because wonder if you don't like it and you're embarrassed. Then, because I consider you a friend at that point, if you're a friend on my Facebook or maybe you see me around Utah, I love to go to Las Vegas. I love to go to Harley Davidson events like Sturgis, Arizona Bike Week, Love Ride. I mean, so many fun events out there. And I want you guys to join me. And if you're making money, and you like motorcycles, and let's go to Sturgis in August. You know, we got a half year to save up, you know, almost a little more than a half year. But if you like to go to Vegas, let's go. I lived there 9 years. I know everything in Vegas. You know, there's probably a couple things I don't know. But when you live there, you know where to go and have fun, and where's a good meal, and where's a good place just to have fun. And I don't mean on the strip. I mean, you know, so I just want more buddies out there. I love the social aspect about what I do. So when it comes down to like making money online, yeah, because everyone's spending money online. Someone has to make money in order for someone to buy something. It's just the way it is. If everything was free online, wouldn't that be badass? So so if you look at my title of tonight's little shindig, it's basically, can I make money online from working at home? Can I make money without sales calls? Yes. Can I make some moolah without talking about the product? Yes. I tell you that I sell information. I don't have enough time in the day to go in the vast amount of information that the company I work with sells, but it's basically marketing. Marketing's pretty easy. It's getting your attention, your brain to go, eyeballs, look at this. Is it interesting? Deet, 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 deet. Yes, click. We do it all day. All we do is search for something online. What does my ex-girlfriend from 12 years ago look like on Facebook? How do I tie a tie? Girls might want some, are they chimichus? Those badass pumps that have the red bottoms? Girls might want some badass pumps. Guys, we probably want Punisher hats. I mean, my God, there's so much cool stuff, but you have to search for something because your mind, you know, got your eyeballs to look at something, and all that is attention. So it's marketing. So if you think you can market, or do you think you can maybe market in a fun way, in an affordable way, then maybe you should kind of listen to what I got to say. And all you got to do is put your name, email address, and if you get a little bit of a inkling to do something, then we'll go to the next step. But what I do is I make money online, but I don't sell it personally. I let the company do it, not with operators from India. Hello, how are you doing? What can I do for you today? And you know what they do in India? They have 5,000 other companies they represent. And when you say, okay, you know, I'm calling with this, they already know because the line says, okay, they're calling for this. They saw infomercial at 2 a.m. The 800 number is 24 hours a day. So they have a full script and they do the best they can to talk as knowledgeable as possible about probably over 100 to 500 products that they really don't care about, because most of the, you know, telemarketing companies, and there's a million right here in Utah, one of the biggest in the world is right 25 minutes away from me, but I think you guys get the gist. If you're just paid to kind of do customer servicing, you know, if a product is so badass, why wouldn't you just go, God, you know, everyone's making money. This is a great company. You'd probably leave customer servicing and join one of the opportunities that you're pretending to give a rat's ass about. I think most people hate telemarketing. They just can't stand it. After a while, people are rude to them. There's chargebacks. There's all this stuff. I really feel bad for people that do customer servicing. That is a tough gig in any business, in person or just on the phone. But if they're going to call the company I work with, when they need something like information, these guys are coaches. They're not customer servicing. They'll answer questions. You guys come up with 500 questions if that's what it takes. But you know what? I'm not going to answer them unless we do live webinars and chit chats like what we're doing right now. And I don't mind. I like to put stupid, simple fun, you know, in everything I do. But the company I work with, they're the ones that are going to go ahead and ease your mind, get your questions answered, see how much it costs, see how you can get paid. You know, if you guys need to make $500 a week, it's not too hard. If you need to make $5,000 or $10,000 a month, it's realistic as hell. It's not some magic potion where you get $5 a sale. The minimum you're going to make, if you want to do what I do, is $500 a sale. A sale that you're never going to really be a part of. And like I tell everyone, if I could slap you guys on the head in a tender way, I don't want anyone to do the sales because you'll mess it up. You'll overtalk about it. You'll make it sound like it's MLM, and it's not. Let people online search for something. And if they need education and our company can provide that, then let the coaches of the company do it. It's just like at the U of U or any college. Let the recruiters recruit. All you do is just go, hey, sir, with the long hair, hey, what's a good college? Hey, the U of U. So let's say someone goes up there and they buy $1,000 of information up there. How cool is it? And today I just get an email and it says, hey, Corey, thanks. This is the U of U. Thanks for that referral. Thanks for sending him up here, because that guy or girl just bought $1,000 of information. 50-50. You just made the college $500 and we're going to pay you $500. That's what, in stupid simple terms, that's what I do. All I do is just post things. I buy solo ads, which is just leads. That's all it is. There's nothing fancy. If you got $100, spend it. Don't be buying more movies. Christmas is going to be okay. If you got to save $500 to educate yourself, or $1,000, so you can make maybe $1,000 a month, maybe you make 20 grand a month. I have now 5 people with this company that have only been doing it 90 days, and they're well over 20 something thousand a month already. Okay. They're not special. They're special people. They're great humans. They're great moms, great dads. They're awesome. And they don't even look as wacky and crazy as I do. And they're just normal people. They did not go to Yale. They didn't go to Harvard. They weren't grandfathered in by the owner of Sony, who knew the Rockefellers, and they got a job and grandfathered in, because that happens in MLM. A lot of people know somebody of somebody, and someone has a ton of money and they buy them their way into a position. And I hate MLM. This is not MLM. This is about just simply promoting something. Take some money. The minimum is $1,000. Tell you straight up. This type of company is not where everything's free. You can take your time and just be lazy and pretend you own a business. And then in 2 weeks you can go, oh God, this sucks. Or maybe in 2 months or something. But all I can tell you is that when you invest money into this company, and you do what you can afford. You can do more than $1,000. They've got all these educational products. And when you buy one, let's say for $1,000, when people buy $1,000 of information, you get half of that. They've got courses that are $2,500. They got courses that are $5,000. They've got courses that are $12,000. How would you like to make half of that? And you know what the effort is? The difference of just talking about an opportunity. Hey man, you know, look at this, go look at that. It's up to them if they want to spend $1,000 to $12,000. We have no, it's their business. We have no business of what anyone's scholarship money goes to. If they go to the U of U, let them spend the money. So when you call the company that I work with, you know, look at their different schedules, see, you know, levels of information, see what you want. And that's all it is. If you have $1,000, great, because you're going to get a lot of information. Hopefully you can learn from it like I have. And then what you're going to do is you're just going to market. You're going to go on Facebook like I'm doing right now. You can do webinars where you can have, you know, plenty of people just, you know, sharing information. I love video. I can help you go to get on video where it's comfortable and it's, you know, and it's awkward and it's fun. The most success I've ever had is being myself, where people know I'm not a paid actor or faking it to make it or doing all this bait and switch bullshit where you pretend to be someone's friend and then you go ahead and tell them about your, man, would you like to save 5 cents on your long distance? Hey, would you like to get 1% of 100 person's efforts worth versus 100% of your own? I mean, I've heard it all and I'm full of shit. I've been in FM radio since 1987. I've heard it all. I've probably cut an ad about something. That's a famous phrase. So, but I don't want to do that. So if you think that you want to make some money online in a humorous, fun way, you don't have to talk to anyone if you don't want to. You don't have to sell anything if you don't want to. All you got to do is just learn how to market. And if you have some extra money, then go ahead and buy some leads. Just instead of buying DVDs or going to the movies or buying that watch, or there's a lot of stuff you really don't need. Pay your rent, pay your water bill, pay your children's education. If they need school clothes and it makes them feel good, then buy them school clothes. You guys know what I'm talking about. I don't need to get into what is morally right and wrong with money and extra money, because I call it FU money. When you have FU money, you buy a Maserati. When you have FU money, you go to the movies. FU money, because it's not cheap. You guys know movies are what, about $15 each? Popcorn's 10, drinks are probably 8, but Is it realistically $50 for you and your wife or girlfriend or brother or kid to go to the movies for two? Yeah, it just is. And my, you know, pardon my French, but that's FU money. That's money that you can afford to go, you know what? Here's $50 for 2 hours. I saw the new Spider-Man. The popcorn made me not go poop for a day. And I drank that big fattening giant Coke and now I'm bloated. But with that FU money, you now feel bloated. You can't poop for a day or two, but you saw the new Spider-Man. So if you have extra money, and if you're my age, I would recommend investing it into something that will make you more money. And I think you know that I've been as materialistic and crazy. No one needs this Corvette. No one needs all these Barbies. No one needs all these little trinkets. They do give me a lot of joy, I'll tell you. I love little trinkets and putting them all over the place and hanging stuff and everything else. But I'm smart enough at my age now, thank God, after almost 53 years, to realize, God, you know what? If I have some extra money, let's just invest it into something that sounds fun, relaxing. I know I can do it. I feel it. I don't like sales, so I don't have to sell anything. I do have a very awesome product, which is overwhelming. It's very stimulating. All it is education. I don't have to beg anyone to buy it because I'm never going to talk to those people. The company is. But if I like Facebook, if I like Instagram, if I have a couple extra bucks for postcards, placing ads, or just going buying solo ads, which is directly this, I've got $100. Please, company, give me this many leads for people searching how to make money online, how to buy online education, how to get people to look at my website. My God, there's all these great searched items out there with companies that all they do, they just generate leads. And if you need 100 of them, then go buy them. Don't buy 2 Spider-Man movies. You do not need this sexy $4 tank top, this $9 hat. You know, that's $13 plus tax. I got $15 of hat and tank top. I didn't really need it. I just thought it was kind of cool to kind of wear a brown tank top that looks like a Hershey chocolate in this hat. I just couldn't resist. But if you have some extra money, then just buy leads. You don't have time to take YouTube classes and then search and do all this stuff. And then don't think you have to brand yourself. You know, I guess the new term now is you're an influencer. It's somebody that's not really famous. They're not like billed as a surgeon or a professor or Dr. Laura. You know, there's a lot of people that are experts. Dr. Drew is good for advice on health. But influencers are, you know, they're kind of well known in business opportunities or how to do this, how to buy real estate. In my age group, there was Carlton Sheets. When it comes down to like good, making yourself feel good and getting out of a rut, Tony Robbins. Those are guys and girls that have really done a great job. They've probably given out some really good advice. Some help, some doesn't. I do know Tony. I love his courses. Great. Carlton Sheets was an old guy that got us into real estate. And now, man, you got all these gurus. But with all the influencers out there, you know, they're just good at kind of being themselves, talking about an opportunity. And if people enjoy what they heard for like, let's say 20 minutes or an hour, then they just go, hey, you know what? I'd like to look into this. And obviously they get their credit card and they just buy something. You guys have done it probably 50 times. I'm telling you guys stuff you guys already know. But if you want to know how to get attention and get eyeballs on a website, on where's the best pizza, how do I buy a home in this city? Oh my God, I mean, I could go, what is there, about 7 trillion things right now being searched for right now. All I want to do is just get a little piece of the pie of people that want to buy some really badass education. But I don't want to go to college. I'm not going to study really all of it. I'm not going to sell any of it. I don't like sales. Wonder if they have 400 questions and I have to go build a Lego set. You know, Lego sets, sometimes they take me 8 hours or 2 days to build. I love doing that. I want to build a Lego set. I don't want to be on the phone all day talking about what I sell and what I do. And then people going, yeah, but how do I do it? Corey, I don't know how to market. I've never done this before. Oh, screw it. I'm going to go to Superman and just spend $50 so I don't shit until 3 days later and just feel fat with Coke. I just got to do it. I got to go see that Superman. His ass is so nice in spandex. That's how crazy life is. People always make up excuses on how to go have fun. How many times have you blown something off because you just got to go outside and watch the sunset? I have. How many times have you just completely come up with bullshit, told your friends, hey, you know what? I got all this other crap to do. I'm sorry. I got to do the laundry. And what you really mean is like, God dang it, I'm going to binge watch that Stranger. Is it Stranger Things? I mean, we all kind of bull crap and we procrastinate. Nothing's funner than just reading and studying for years and years and years and never taking action. How many times have you heard that in one of those courses? Just take action. Come on, take action. That's what you got to do. I'll never beg anybody to do anything. That's like me as crazy as going, no, now stop smoking. Just say no. People stop smoking when they literally stop smoking. People are going to stop drinking beer. People, you know, that's, I'm going to call my friends tomorrow and go, don't you dare watch NFL football all day tomorrow while I'm probably watching NFL football all day tomorrow. So, you know what I mean? Leading a horse to water and making it drink. That's the same as me trying to put on a suit, look a little better, shave, and be nice and humble, shake someone's hand, where I'm so desperate, I want to beg them to buy something. And I am their friend. I'm not that low. But, you know, if you're a salesman and, you know, God, you could be in the car business for 5 days straight, let's say showing 20 cars, and they're just, it's tire kickers. It's just where a person wants to just test drive a bunch of stuff before they buy. And that's, I don't blame it. But then, you know, you got to ask yourself, if you do show 20 cars and no one buys, you do get mad. You even get mad at the potential buyer. But then if you were in their shoes, you would want to test drive and look at the colors. And maybe you love the new Corvette, but you're too tall. I'm 6'2", 220. I don't fit in almost any badass car that I love, but I fit in all trucks and SUVs. But I'll tell you what, if I wanted to go buy a badass Corvette, let's say, or a Camaro, or I mean, I personally like the new Challengers. Those TASRT Challengers. God, I love those. I'd want a convertible one, but they don't sell the convertible yet. I hope they do. But if I wanted to go buy a real one, I'd want to sit in it, drive it around. I'd want to drive maybe the manual and the automatic. I'd want the sunroof. And I'd want to test drive a few. So as a buyer, that's smart. But when you're a salesman and you got to wait for someone to come in, I can't do that. And no diss to anyone that does that, because some of my best friends do that right now. And they make a great living. They take care of their families. And thank goodness they do that. Because if you are lucky enough to buy a new vehicle, new or used, you do need somebody to shake your hand, test drive it, make sure everything's honky-dory. And then you can drive that badass new car or truck home. So for me, I don't want to do that. I've owned a car dealership in Vegas. I've ran radio stations. I've owned 4 nightclubs that have done everything from hip hop to gay and lesbian. Yes, that's right. I've had drag queens get up there and shake their bums. I have had the craziest nights in my clubs, from hip hop, top 40. I've produced the Ultimate Combat Fights, which is MMA fighting. So I've got over 30 years of nightclub ownership. If I wanted to do it, I'd go do it. I just don't want it anymore. I don't want to be around alcohol and profit off certain things like that anymore. Just not me, that's all. And nightclubs, we need them so people can go dance and have a good time. Sports bars. So no disrespect to any of those. It's just not for me anymore, that's all. I sold 600 and something cars when I lived in Vegas, just as a wholesaler, just myself. I didn't even have employees. My son helped me now and then and a couple of my good buddies. But I do like selling cars to a degree, but it'd be like, hey, if I had some cool Wave Runners for sale, or maybe there's like a Hemi Cuda, or, you know, but it's more of a hobby type thing than me going to work every day and selling something. And I just can't do it. And if you think you don't want to do it either, you could probably, you know, do what I do, which is just sell some badass information to people and let them decide on what level and how much they want to spend. It's not my business. Of course, the more they spend, just, you know, you can see what the company does on how you can, you know, get, how do you want? Do you want to get half of $6,000? Do you want to get half of that $12,000? It's crystal clear. It's simple. This company says 50-50. If someone's kind enough to go through you of however they found it to buy $1,000 of education, in order for you to get 500 of it, Corey, you've got to buy that course yourself. You can throw it in the garbage, you can delete it, or you can go ahead and download it and look at the information, because I think you should definitely study you know, the business opportunity, or maybe how to get direction, or how to get traffic, or how to build a website. I mean, it's up to you. But if you don't worry about it. You absolutely don't have to know anything about the education that people will buy from the company I work with. But it's this simple. If you want half of that $1,000 course, you simply have to buy that course. You don't have to do it every month. There is no minimums. There is no MLM and all this other horse shit. It's just simply, you know what? Someone bought a $1,000 course today, and it looks like through your Facebook posts, your Instagram posts, maybe you bought some leads, maybe you sent out some postcards. You've heard of people handing stuff out at gas stations. I mean, that's all old school stuff. But if you're kind of a little lazy like me, what I do is I'm lucky enough to make a couple, you know, extra bucks, FU money. And what I do is I just get a really legit badass company and I say, give me 100 leads. I need 500 leads. Because out of 500 people, if they're searching for certain information and my company, you know, who I work with, has it, what are the odds that, let's say, 500 leads buy one course, maybe the minimum of 1,000? I'll make 500 bucks. Can I get one person to just go ahead and buy the minimum course? We are not going door to door. We're not getting lucky and trying to spam people on email. These are people already searching just for information. All we're doing is just standing in front. It's like they're walking at like a swap meet. And let's say the aisle is selling screwdrivers and tools and all that stuff. Because I love swap meets and I always go in the tool sections. But what are the odds that if I look like a mechanic, I've got some money in my pocket, and I'm walking down the swap meet, down an aisle of nothing but used tools, and they're affordable, and that's what I want. I might even on my shirt say, you know, that I'm a mechanic. But what are the odds that I probably are going to buy something when I'm walking down these aisles? It's a pretty high probability, and I'm not going to be mad if all I have is tools to look at. I'm not walking down looking at used music or maybe the girls section of, maybe there's like a whole bunch of girls' clothes, but I'm trying to find screwdrivers. You know what I mean? Even at Walmart, if you guys want food, you go to the left side. If you guys want tires, you go to the back. If you want to go pee, you go to the back. If you want to get fat, you go to the McDonald's in the front left with the red box machine. If you want to get your nails done, you go to the front of Walmart and you go where it says Happy Salon. I really don't know what they're called, but you know what I mean? You're not pissing people off and spamming people if you are giving them something that they are requesting. So if you think that, oh, I don't know, I don't want to do video. I don't know Instagram. Oh, I'm old school. I'm a farmer. I'm not going to do, you know. But if you're lucky enough to have some FU money, could be 50 bucks, could be 1,000 bucks. You might even have $50,000. I know people that have way more than that. It's just the equity of their home, but they don't do anything with it. They're just like, I'm just going to keep a little nest egg. Good for you guys. But if you want to pull some money out and buy some education on how to make money online, I would recommend doing that. We're all running out of time. Once that sand is down, hey, Grim Reaper, I'm waiting for that guy with the hoodie and that big old, what is it? Is it a seer? What's that called? The big thing in the Grim Reaper. Is it a scythe? I forgot what it's called, but you guys know what I mean. We're all running out of time. But everyone asks me every day now, because I've been doing a lot of these live little chit-chat things. I mostly do them all over the internet, but I've been doing them on my live feed just on Facebook. And I love it because I have nothing to hide. I usually do stupid things, fart jokes. I talk about heavy metal in my radio shows and all this stuff. But right now, I just have a fun time. You know, I've got multiple Facebook accounts and business accounts and everything else. But I just like to shoot the shit with you guys and have fun. And people now almost daily just go, well, what do you do? And I just say, go to CoreyDraper.com. And fill out your name. You can put Farrah Fawcett. You can put Dildo. I don't care. But just put a real email address so that you can watch a 20-minute video. If it sounds somewhat interesting, then let's go to the next level. Get an email. Get a text. Call the company. Talk to a badass coach. Real person. And his best interest is to put all your questions in the filing cabinet that says answered. They comprehend what it is. And he or she will just go, what other questions? just let me know, because there's a lot of companies out there where you got to do a ticket. And I mean, God, it's like all these Zendesk. And I mean, have you ever wanted to ask a question to a company? And like even Facebook, good luck trying to get a human on the phone and go, yeah, you know what? I got a question, Facebook. How do I turn off the beeps every time I do a live video? You know, I prefer a company that says, you know what? Let's just talk a little bit if you have some concerns, or just go, just move on. There's a million other things to search and have fun with online. But if you're interested in what Corey had to say, or maybe someone else, then let's go ahead and just chat. Let's just talk. But tell me when I should call you. Because the company, sometimes if they just pick up the phone and call at 10 in the morning, well, wonder if you're at work. Wonder if you drop your kids off at 7:50 in the morning, and then they call you at 8 o'clock and you're not home yet until 8:05. So let the company know, hey, text, email. I prefer the phone. That way, you know, it's a real live person. No, they're not sourced. They're not in another country. They are coaches. They work full time for this company. And you know what the deal is? 50 effing 50. I like that. I work just as hard marketing and bullshitting with my Punisher hat as much as they on the phone put all of your questions and stuff, whatever that stuff is. Boy, that stuff could be amazing. But if it takes you 1 hour of questions and you're scared shitless and you don't want to lose money, and if you don't know what you're doing, then I don't mind. If you get a hold of me, that's why I'm live on my Facebook feed. This is my real name. I've been on Facebook since about the week after it debuted. I can't remember if it was 05 or 08, but I believe in this company so much that I don't mind using my personal Facebook accounts and businesses to my radio shows and other companies that I have. I ain't gonna do that if I don't believe the company has something of value, first of all, because I'm not gonna meet you guys on the street and then you guys punch me in the face and steal my Punisher hat, because it's shiny ball, it's MLM, it's shampoos, motions, lotions, potions. There's a lot of stuff out there to pretend to sell so you can qualify each month to get 1% of a 1%, and this kicks over so you can get 1% of the guy that lives over here that gets 7% from the girl that gets 2%. I'd give two shits about that. If it's MLM, I'm gone. See ya. I'm best buddies with the owners and founders of one of the biggest MLMs in the world. They're based right here in Utah. I still don't do MLM. But I do like selling something that I think is valuable. It'll change your life. And I think if you do what I do, it's, I stress more usually. This one's more about like, can I make a buck online? But I believe honestly that if you're in a rut and it's just nice to meet some cool people out there that are struggling, they're in the same boat as you, but one lives in Nebraska, the other one might live in Fiji. That happens. I met 47 people, I think, today. I feel like SHIT, if I don't meet and correspond with around 50 new people a day, they come to me, which makes me feel so great that somehow they got a hold of my Facebook or something and they thought something was interesting. Either I look like, just a fried-haired maniac, or maybe one of my posts is funny. Maybe my radio show's interesting, or maybe I put something real serious about life. But when people come to me, I love it. I couldn't be more honored, because they're the ones, God, you know what? Happy birthday. Or, oh man, I'm sorry about this. Or, hey, what's going on with that? I love it. So if I don't meet like 50 people a day, I honestly go into convulsions like, oh my God, what did I do? Do I really need to put a suit on and a haircut and go wait all day for someone to walk in the door and buy a widget from me? But I really like the social aspect of it. So if you're kind of shy, or you feel like, you know what, I'm just stuck at home a lot and I live in a small town, or I don't have a ton of money, but I do have a little bit of FU money so I can invest into something that's more believable. I just recommend selling information that's really valuable versus selling, let's say, an armchair. Now, if someone needs an armchair, there's a lot of competition. Here in Utah, good criminy, there's a lot. And by the time you go online, if you can wait a week for it to get delivered, it's probably half that on Amazon. But I just really like selling information. The word digital products is really popular, but I'm going to just keep it stupid and very simplistic. And that's just basically, if people are out there and they want some information, I would like to get like a couple bucks if they go ahead and find out about this company that's selling it. I'm like a dating service. Hey, Corey, do you know anyone that's single and wants to go to the football game? Yeah, there's this girl over here. She's so cool, man. She's like my friend's this, and you better treat her right or I'll kick your butt. But you know what? Yeah, she loves football. You know what? It's like that guy goes, God, you know what? She's the coolest girl. I'm going out with her again. And then like in a year or two, they marry. That's kind of how I feel. If I can lead someone in a direction, either to better their company or get eyeballs on their business or make some bucks, yeah, and you can make $500 a week by just having one person stumble in to the company I work with and just go, you know what? I've been kind of negative on stuff and I don't know anyone that makes money online. And I just, you know, I don't think I can do it. You know, I'm kind of a grumpy old farmer. I'm retired now. And I don't know. I mean, this internet thing, it's kind of cool, but it's just not for me. It's like, well, why not? Because there's a lot of people that are older making tons of money that just be themselves. They look in the camera and all of a sudden you're like, oh my God, that looks like my grandpa with a corn cob pipe and a button nose. He sat on a tractor and he always had great stories about this and that. And like, you're like, oh my God, my grandpa's online just talking about stuff, doing funny stories. And you know, and then all of a sudden he's got a couple grand coming in a month. Maybe he's got $5,000 a month coming in. And you're like, oh my God, that's my grandpa. He's like 69 years old. And my God, I just thought he sat on the porch smoking his corn cob pipe, talking about the good old days. I recommend that the more real you are, and I mean, don't dress up and fake it to make it. If you can do video like I'm talking to you fine folks right now, I think you're going to feel better just spiritually, mentally. You'll get out of your rut if you feel like you're stuck or you're just not social. You're going to meet so many cool people. And like I said, if I don't meet 50 people a day, I feel like poop. And I just love it. All over the world, they just come in. And I'm like, God, I got a friend in Singapore. Where the hell is Singapore again? I have to look it up. And I had another person get a hold of me from a country I never heard of. I didn't realize there was like 5,000 countries out there I never even heard of. But, even a girl now, if you're watching, my first friend from Colombia. And dang it, I wish I had all my feeds up. I have all my computer shut down, but I met a pretty girl today. She's just in Colombia. And how cool is that? I mean, you know, who the heck knows anyone in Colombia in the United States? It's very rare. We hear stories about Colombia and all the crazy stuff that happened in the 80s and Miami. But man, to know that someone is just kicking back in Colombia, is it Medellin? I always thought it was like Magellan or Medellin or whatever, but Medellin, or I always say all the country or the cities wrong there. But that made my day today. I got to meet someone just about an hour ago. High five to you, by the way, from Colombia. And one of my good buddies used to live there. He used to teach. He's a super well-known guy online. I'll just say his name, man. Justin. Justin Varengia. Couldn't ask for a cooler guy. His pretty wife, Dee. I've been off and on businesses with those guys forever, man. And my God, he used to live in Colombia. Now he's got just a house, beautiful wife, kick-ass daughter. Lives in beautiful Puerto Rico. And boy, he used to live in a 300 square foot apartment. I know his story down to a T. So you can come up with a lot of excuses. And if that's what you want to do, that's okay. Cause I'm so full of crap. I know that I've probably lied and bullcrapped about, you know, how I want to not do something and how negative the world is. Or, oh my God, I read the news today and the government is going to impeach and the Dow Jones inflation is going to go up because the economy and the Dow Jones, like, who gives a shit? You should be outside watching the sunset, barbecuing, because winter's coming fast where I live in Utah. If you live in Florida, man, you need to be on the beach just watching the waves come in. If you live in Vegas, you know what? Go have a badass steak dinner and go check out a badass show on the Strip. Or if you live in Montana, go whitewater rafting. Don't be watching TV and all the negative bullcrap, because Amazon's getting bigger. Windows is coming up with more badass stuff. Flat screen TVs are getting more affordable. You know, there's always a watch that you need probably that's being built right now. Plenty of money out there, plenty of opportunity. So many people are just shy and scared shitless about coming out of their shell. Don't worry about that part. It's so exciting. Like I said, I almost feel like a success coach. Come on, you can do it. I can't help but be how I am right now. My whole life, it's like, tone it down. Whoa. I've always been the guy that comes in like full throttle. Then I got to pull back. I got to hit those brakes. I got to put the parachute on the back of the space shuttle to slow my ass down. Because when you really believe in something and it's fun, you know, how can you not be excited? So, but anyway, you know, tonight I just wanted to say hello. You know, I focus on good old European countries, and boy, those Asian countries are way ahead. And if you guys don't mind, this was ice cold pomegranate juice. Talk about stain. Look at that. Can you see it by cup? Where's my, okay, see that? Look at that. It is like completely stained my brand new favorite coffee cup. And this better wash out, because I'm going to have this cup another 30 years. I promise you, in 2050, if I'm lucky enough to live to 83 years old, I will have this surfer cup by my best pal Val. I will have no teeth. I will be in a diaper. I will be bald as hell. And I will still be doing fart jokes and crazy stuff on Facebook or Instagram, or who knows what's going to be around in even 5 years. These darn cell phones are so badass. I hope that I have good motor skills and eyeballs, because, you know, if I'm in a wheelchair or I'm in a retirement home and I've got one of these darn things, I'll tell you what, man, I'll be like, damn, I love this. I'll still be doing like, okay, do the cat. Okay, do the dog where he's throwing himself a bone and catching it and stuff. And yeah, I collect like the funniest videos of the day and I just post them on my Facebook account. But I'll tell you what, if I can just put on the craziest videos of the day at 83 years old, man, that's a good day to me. I do that now at almost 53. So, all right. Well, I'm going to go ahead and do another, shindig in about 15 minutes. I just, this was just kind of like, see what you guys are up to, get your interests going, see if you would like just some more information about what I do. And all I do is just kind of like act like a bum, like a butthole. And if people are interested in going to just a website, CoreyDraper.com, FreedomBabyYeah.com. I've got about 90 some odd websites. I just pay 10, 15 bucks at GoDaddy. I go ahead and make them private for like another 10 bucks. So for like 20 something bucks, if the domain isn't taken, you know, let's just say your name is Bob Smith. BobSmith.com, go to GoDaddy, and all you do is forward. You go to the DNS. And if you don't know how, just call GoDaddy. They'll do it for you. GoDaddy's awesome. I've never had a problem with them ever. They've solved my problem badly. And I know my websites with my live radio stations are way more complicated than any simple website out there. But I just recommend GoDaddy. They're open 24 hours a day. Customer service, smart as a whip. If a whip's smart, they got smart whips there. But, you know, if in general you're like, well, kind of give me the, you know, give me the kindergarten overview. You know, K-I-S-S, keep it simple, sweetheart. I had a good friend tell me that. The word stupid, I hate that word, isn't it? It's just awful. But keep it simple, sweetheart. Even if you're a guy out there, I'll call you sweetheart. That's how confident I am in my sexuality. I will call you sweetheart. But, you know, basically, you know, if you got a couple bucks, you know, you're going to buy either the lowest level course. That way you can get 500 bucks. Coming in, you know, I want you to get 10 500 buck sales first month, because I know most people can live off 5 G's. If you made 5 grand the first month, do you think you're going to be motivated to do it the next month and the next month of just making videos, talking about stuff, posting things? Or if you have extra FU money, just buy the leads. Let the leads dump into your website that you don't even have to maintain. But a capture page is nothing more than this. Put your name and your email address in this box and hit click. The website goes to another page that says, watch this 20-minute video. And if you want the company to contact you, or you want to contact them, when and where. And if you don't want to do it, no problem at all. No skin off my bum, because I'm going to be on Facebook and YouTube anyway, screwing off. I just want to make some extra bucks. I want to make crazy money, actually, because my effort to make 500 bucks a pop is just as easy as making 6 to 12,000 bucks a pop. So, and I think the company's coming up with even more education. So could you imagine if someone buys $25,000 course and you can get half of that? Just one sale, my God, you're set the whole month. Who can't live off $12,000 in 1 month? If you can't, that's awesome. Because there's plenty of people that their mortgage is $12,000 a month, you know, for that big ass castle house, you know, and good for you. That's the exciting thing about living in America, or just basically living anywhere on the planet. There's plenty of millionaires out there. Are they better than you? Are they smarter than you? Did they get grandfathered into an inheritance? And, you know, I mean, if they did, good for them. I watched a documentary the other day about Woodstock, most famous classic rock mess of a concert ever in 1969. It was a young kid. He inherited money because his parents died and they founded Polydent. You know what Polydent is? I'm going to know real quick, because when all my teeth fall out, that Polydent is like that glue stuff that your dentures. Now, in my age group, I used to have like older people talk, and then their choppers, sometimes their teeth would move. The other day, Joe Biden, he's trying to be our president. He was talking the other day, and he has all fake teeth. But you can go to YouTube right now and start talking and type in Joe Biden teeth fallout. Well, he's talking. Well, guys, let me tell you, I'm going to give you free education. And he starts going like this because his teeth started falling out. So he had to go and then bite down hard because that Polydent, it's basically like gum. But anyway, the founders of that, they left a considerable amount of money to this young kid. And if it wasn't for him, there'd be no Woodstock, because he was the guy that funded it. Woodstock in 69 was almost $3 million. That's like having a $70 million concert today. The problem is they didn't have fencing, proper food, proper toilets. They did it in a field in upstate, you know, north of New York, Manhattan. When the concert started, all the gates were down. And there's a famous clip. It shows this guy talking to the promoter. And he's all, do you realize that you just threw the biggest freebie in the history of rock and roll, because they had no way to get their money back? All the fences fell down anyway. So it was just awesome, just crazy. But thank goodness that guy was lucky enough to get all this money to pay for Woodstock. And you know, he lost all his money and it took him till 1980 to recover. And the concert was 11 years prior. So my point is, if you're lucky enough to, you know, inherit billions and millions, you know, good for you. But most of us, we have to kind of work, come up with some good ideas, try to find a product or a service where people would like, you know, to spend some money on what we do or what we sell. And that's it. So anyway, I'll just keep this one a little shorter. Corey Draper here, if you guys don't know who I am. And if you just want to get the ball rolling, just go to CoreyDraper.com. At the end of this video thing, I always upload it to YouTube. I do it here on Facebook, and then you'll see my links. Or just freedombabyyeah.com. That's my Austin Powers company. Yeah is Y-E-A-H. freedombabyyeah.com. You're not contracted. You're not going to get spammed. I'm not going to call you at 4 a.m. and say, wake up. You know, I got something to talk to you about. This is just something, you know, if you need to make some money or a shitload of money, this is a cool way to do it. It's affordable and realistic. And I wouldn't do it if it sucked. I ain't going to put my own Facebook feeds and put my own name on the table when I don't believe in something. And I'm really serious about that. No shiny ball bullshit here. The only shiny ball, like I said, if I have my hat off, my big fat head. So I got this horrible lighting. They're trying to get rid of it. Is it cadence or incandescent? I always say that wrong, but you know, the lighting that makes you look really good. They're trying to get rid of that because I guess the ozone, or I don't know. I don't even know if it really does ruin stuff or not. But the way that lighting is going, it's amazing. It's more efficient, but it really makes you look weird. You know, it gives you more cracks. It makes, like, my webcam looks more blurry than it actually is. And I mean, my hands are, I mean, even the color, like, I mean, I look barbecue flavored right now. So anyway, you guys all know the bull crap. So, okay, I'll go ahead and end this. And then the next one, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to share my screen and just kind of show what I do without my big mouth just telling you about it. And sometimes just looking at a screen is kind of cool, because if you do what I do, you're going to basically be seeing what I'm seeing. It's that simple, man. So, all right, I'll be back. Give me like 15 minutes. I'm going to go get this in another cup, because this really does piss me off. This pomegranate juice, my God, if it ruined my cup, I'm going to have a sheet fit. So, all right, man, take care. Give me like 15 minutes if you're watching me live. And if this is a recording, what's going on? It's 1974 right now. It's December 4th, 1974. Okay. I'll see you guys. Give me 15 minutes. Peace and love. See you in a bit.